Hi there. Meet Beard. Behind the camera. We got good old Weedo over here. Hello. Coming at you. Right? And we're going to discuss what I hear. I got the issues, man. I got major issues. You see, I got this book here. It's a massive chip. And you're like, why did you buy this, bro? Why did you buy this book? And I did not intend to buy this book in this condition for what I paid for it. And this is why I'm making this video. Now, I'm not going to shout out names. I'm not going to be like, yo, bro, that sucks. He goes, yeah, it sucks big time, yo. Right? And I just paid, like I said, I got a mid-price reader copy. Now I'm still on the hunt for this book. I want this book in a pristine, raw copy. And you're gonna probably be like, where'd you buy that, bro? Like, dude, I bought this on Amazon. I'm not gonna give you this is the blunt story. Bought on Amazon, the price was like fitted for the photo that they have up, head up. Now, that photo was not this book. It was not this torn up, you know, reader's copy. Now, I'm still stoked I have it, but I'm not that stoked because what I paid for it. Dude, and this happened before, right? Like, I bought a She-Hulk Volume 4, and it had the red bar. And when I got the book, it was a green bar, straight up. It was a third print. And I actually had more value, I would say, than the first book, the first print run. I was like, yo, dude, you know, I'll take it. That's a good one. And then I was like watching Steve Said Boom. And they were doing the Defenders issue, right? And I was like, I wanted that book now. And I was, dude, I went to Amazon and I got a good copy. You know, I got a decent copy. You know? Stoked. He read it to me, page by page. So I know what happened. Right? And then a couple days later he had it on sale. Another one. Or the thing annual. Or 2-in-1. But this is not cool. This was not the picture. I'm probably repeating myself, but this is how disturbed I am a little bit that this is what they threw at me, man. You know, and all it does is encourages me because I'm not an eBay guy. And, you know, the why, Jordy? You know what? Because I thought this kind of stuff would be coming my way with through eBay. You know, oh, you should do it more often. I'm going to be doing something, man. So, I guess this is a big shock to me that somebody would do that. That's kind of low ball, man. I got one shop. I'm going to do this, dude, bro. I got one shop. And then he sent me baseball cards in my package. I got a Ricky Nolasco. And, Jeff, and to me, this is kind of like, you need rollerbladers to support your industry. Now, comic book shops got to run on this kind of, stuff. And I'm not a sports guy. I skateboard. I'm an old skateboard dude. And I do not, I'm not much of a fan of baseball cards or any team sports in the matter. So that kind of you put, you know, always in perspective what the comic book industry kind of it has its footing, you know, like the sports car industry has its foot on the comic book. And this is a this beautiful cover. This is, you know, I'm going to read it tonight. So, just want to let you know, because you probably saw what I go through my video, like, why did you buy that crappy book? It's not that crappy. But it is, it's a book that I've been wanting to own. I saw it on an auction the other day, and I bought another book. I bid on a book, but I saw that on the same day on the other auction. It was like, oh, I already made my choice, because we all have limited funds, right? So thank you for watching with the issues, bro. And I brought upon you an issue of mine. And I'm going to open this box later on after I have a couple more of these. Now hold. Ha ha! Zoma's got a crush on Peter, baby. Oh, it's so heavy. Yeah. Well, good nights and good evening.